It is devastating. Here we go. John, I'm going to ask you simply, did The Undertaker make the right move challenging Kali to no holds barred tonight?
I think it's stupid. Absolutely not. You got a world championship match. You got Hell in a Cell with Batista, the Animal. Why would you step into the carnage that's going to happen in a no holds barred with the great Kali?
Because Undertaker's the phenom. He's the legend. He's ruled his yard in the WWE for 17 years.
I don't know why the hell The Undertaker wants to stare at me. That's what got him in trouble last week. He needs to take care of business against the great Kali. That's what he needs to worry about.
No holds barred, no rules. Undertaker with the great Kali, and here we go. The best pure striker in the history of the game. The Undertaker going right to work on a 7'3", 420-pound former world champion. Strategy, John, first for The Undertaker.
Get his hands flowing. That is what Undertaker, when he's at his absolute best, he's throwing bones.
Undertaker perhaps going to go old school, going up to the top rope. Kali's in trouble. Undertaker crushing the shoulder of Kali.
Kali doesn't go down, though. Michael doesn't even go to a knee.
Undertaker.
No way. No way.
120-pound man.
My God.
With a choke slam. The cover by The Undertaker. There's two and a kick out by Kali. And Rutgers better calm himself down. Undertaker controlling Kali. Can the Phenom keep it up when we return? We are back on Friday Night SmackDown. No holds barred. The great Kali and The Undertaker. And it is almost fitting that this arena has filled with that fog and that smoke as the great Kali is just manhandling the Phenom. The 7'3", 420-pounder, John, but Undertaker with a big haymaker. Trying to get back in it, but Kali's right hand drops The Undertaker to his knees. John, you know The Undertaker has adapted his game so many times over the years. Different styles for different opponents. But perhaps he has met his match in this giant human being.
Never seen The Undertaker in better shape ever. The 15 years he's been here, he's never looked better, never wrestled better, never fought better. Listed, if you notice, Michael, tonight at 299 pounds. First time you've ever seen him listed below three bills.
But again, he's adapted his style. Sometimes a bit more technical now, but he's just being manhandled. He's being punished by Kali. Cover, hook to the leg, and Undertaker kicks at it too.
People always ask, what was the secret to longevity? It's simple Darwinism. You adapt or you don't survive. The Undertaker is a master at adaptation.
And we talk about the punishment The Undertaker has taken in this matchup. He's made it a career of withstanding punishment, being able to take it all and wear his opponent down.
Understands enough, he's not going to overpower the great Kali. Just learn that lesson right there with that headbutt.
Well, you know what he does a lot of times, Undertaker, John, is like that rope-a-dope Ali style. He sort of lets his opponent punch himself out. But Kali now punching himself out. And almost had a win in this no-holds-barred matchup. Uh-oh. And Kali with a football-sized hand.
This is something, Michael, you don't learn to adapt to. This is something you just hope to survive.
Look at the way Kali's hand envelops the entire shoulder of The Undertaker. When is the last time you saw the look on the face of The Undertaker that you see in there? Come on.
This is why I say Undertaker taking this match was not smart. He has Batista in 9 days. Batista, the Animal, Hell in the Cell.
Hey, earlier tonight, Batista said he was pulling for The Undertaker. He wants The Undertaker to come out of this matchup with a win. Wants The Undertaker to be 100% heading into Survivor Series. And look at Undertaker back to his feet. And the Phenom, rights and lefts. Now the body shots to the great Kali.
I think the worst thing Batista could have done was beat The Undertaker at the last pay-per-view Cyber Sunday.
You got a motivated Undertaker who just ran into a huge elbow. Every time The Undertaker musters some offense, Great Khali knocks him right back down again.
You can't coach size. You can't teach strength.
Khali just measuring The Undertaker. There's the big chop. Undertaker still on his feet. And oh no, the vice grip. The vice grip. Those massive hands and palms and fingers wrapped around the skull of The Undertaker.
Undertaker's done. No one has ever, ever got out of the vice grip.
Khali wearing Undertaker down, much like he did last week.
This is what I mean. 9 days away from a world championship with Batista. Why would Undertaker take this chance?
The vice grip, which has taken out Kane and Flair and Jeff Hardy and Batista and Mysterio and The Undertaker, is locked into the Phenom again. Undertaker with body shots.
Let me reiterate, Michael, no one, including The Undertaker, has ever broke this.
Undertaker back to his feet.
And in no hold barred, you can't get to the ropes and get a break from Mickey Henson.
And he broke it! Undertaker broke the vice grip! Can you believe it? Khali in trouble! Chokeslam!
Four bills plus.
Shoulders down! Two! And Khali kicked out!
No way.
There's no way.
No way.
There is no way Undertaker is going to go for the tombstone pile driver with his massive humanity. And Khali countered. And a clubbing blow to the back of the neck. Went for the vice grip again this time. Look at this. Double slam.
Ball game. Triangle choke.
The triangle choke is locked in. Can he get it? He's got to get that leg over it. Undertaker, he's got it in. He's got the triangle choke locked in.
He's got it cinched in. There's no break on the ropes. There's no break on anything.
No one's ever broken out of the triangle choke in the middle of the ring like this. Undertaker's got it implied.
And it's cinched deep.
The submission maneuver. And Khali
tapped out. He tapped.
Can you believe it?
Makes The Undertaker so dangerous. On his back, he wins the match. Look at this, Khali unconscious. Undertaker did that from his back. You're telling me that's not dangerous? You're telling me that's not adaptation? You're telling me Batista better watch this and worry about the fact he has got this man, the Phenom, in Hell in a Cell in 9 days for the world championship.
Are we looking at the new world champion?
I don't see how we couldn't be, Michael. All kudos to Batista. He's never been better. He's never been in better shape. This right here is a motivated dead man. Just won a match against a 420-pound man from his back.
And that's what it's all about, the world title. Will the Devil's Playground be the Undertaker's yard? Hell in a Cell versus Batista for the